Let's take a look at one more example. A company found the demand for its product to be d of x equal to the square root of 600 minus x. Find the elasticity function. I'll go ahead and write that out again. Okay, on this problem we have to find the derivative of this, which is going to require the chain rule. So let's go ahead and rewrite this so we can work with it. Meaning, I'm going to write d of x is equal to 600 minus x raised to the 1/2 power. Remember, the square root is the same as the 1/2 power. Therefore, for our elasticity function, okay, the derivative of this would be what? 1/2 times 600 minus x raised to the negative 1/2 power. Remember, times negative 1 over our demand function. And I'm going to go ahead and write it in, using a rational exponent. Okay, now I didn't leave enough room, so I'm going to go ahead and clean this up and write it down below here. Now there's several things going on here. First thing I notice, there's a negative x times a negative 1. So I have a positive x in the numerator. Now this 2 would end up in the denominator. And remember that if I took this, since this is all being multiplied together, if I took this 600 minus x raised to the negative 1/2 power and moved it down to the denominator, remember it's going to make this exponent into a positive 1/2. So therefore, I would add the exponent here, which would result in the denominator being 600 minus x to the first power. Okay, let's go ahead and look at part B. Again, this is the answer for part A. Find the elasticity at price x equals 98. So we need to find E of 98. So we have 98 in the numerator divided by 2 times. Now 600 minus 98 would be 502. And this is going to equal 0.098. Again, this is very inelastic, which again, an increase in price will bring an increase in revenue. Lastly, we want to find the price or value of x for which revenue is a maximum. Remember that that's when the elasticity is equal to 1. So what we're going to do now is take our elasticity function, set it equal to 1, and solve. I like to do cross product, so I'm going to write this as 1 over 1, which means that if I do my cross products, x times 1 must equal 2 times the quantity 600 minus x times 1. Distribute the 2. Add 2x to both sides, divide by 3, x is equal to 400. The price of $400 will maximize our revenue. So the price of $98 is way too low if we want to maximize revenue. I hope that helps explain elasticity of demand and some of its applications. Thank you for tuning in and have a good day.